discretionary viewer participation is adjusted for the following World Wrestling Federation event. This week on All Star Wrestling, to join us, Greg the Hammer Valentine, the master of the figure four leg lock. To join us as well, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, Dr. D, David Schultz, along with Cowboy Bob Orton. Also, Special Delivery Jones squaring off against Rowdy Roddy Piper in our feature confrontation. We'll be back with that and more.
Under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the telecast, including the imposition of a charge without the express written consent of the World Wrestling Federation and Titan Sports, is prohibited. In the ring in a moment, ladies and gentlemen, Tito Santana, the reigning Intercontinental Champion, in a non-title matchup, squaring off against Tony Russo at 243 pounds. Both men approximately the same weight, although obviously that weight distributed somewhat differently.
Well, Russo very big in the upper torso.
Monday night, the 2nd of April, this Monday night, the Saunders Trades and Technical High School in Yonkers will have a big World Wrestling Federation card with such great stars as S.D. Jones and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Saunders Trades and Technical High School, Yonkers, New York, this Monday. Then Tuesday, this Tuesday night, April 3rd, at the Holy Cross High School Gym in Queens, New York, you'll feast your eyes on such greats as Dr. D, David Schultz, and Tito Santana, Holy Cross High School in Queens, this Tuesday, April 3rd.
Russo with it now. A nice maneuver. Santana going with the flow and maintaining his hold. Santana with legions of fans all over the entire World Wrestling Federation. Nice takedown a moment ago. Again, Santana maintains control.
Well, Tito Santana truly arriving when he picked up the Intercontinental Championship. That has been a big feather in his hat. Beautiful, beautiful takedown of the part of the great Mexican star, Tito Santana. Very much dominating this particular bout.
Santana going through thick and thin to climb the ladder of success throughout the World Wrestling Federation. Going downstairs now, Tony Russo, as Russo backs off and hammers away with a forearm. Russo, face first, sending Santana to the buckle, face first moments ago, now hammering into the back. Russo now with another uppercut, this time a forearm, another one. And Santana retaliating in like fashion, although with obviously a little bit more behind his punches.
Oh, look at that. Tito Santana, the catalyst feed, of course, when Mr. Russo took a couple of shots at the Intercontinental Champion. He's a very explosive individual. I'm talking about Tito Santana, of course.
Referee right in on the action as we move in a little closer now, and Tony Russo back to his feet as Santana against the rope. Referee asking for the clean break, and Russo not giving it to him at all, giving it rather to Santana in the abdominal area. Knee lift. Santana winding up Russo. Pretty much of a seesaw battle here to open up things here on All Star Wrestling. Takedown. Very basic one by Santana.
Working on that left arm and shoulder of the native of Palermo, Sicily, Tony Russo. Santana, the complete wrestling package. What a career he has had. Wow! That shows a little bit of that background in professional football. Followed up with an arm drag takedown for Tito Santana.
Russo, under normal circumstances, certainly would give any an opponent, as he is giving Santana, great difficulty. Rather unusual style possessed by Tony Russo, and certainly a very short, squat torso is tough to deal with, as opposed to Santana's more long, light type physique. Knee lift. Santana countering with a forearm and another one. Russo, tough hombre. Able to absorb most of the shock from those blows. Now the hammer locked by Tito Santana.
Well, Santana clearly Vince, the crowd favorite here this week. It is World Wrestling Federation event. Popular champion, as you alluded to earlier, wherever he happens to travel.
Elbow. And a forearm, and now Tony Russo beginning to assert himself. Another knee lift. Santana, back to his feet, now kicking, stomping. Up goes Russo, down to the canvas. And a drop kick by Santana.
Wow.
Santana to the rope. Oh, wow, what a forearm. The cover hooks the leg. Get the jump. Tito Santana victorious. And indeed, he does have his fans here by the thousands this week.
Hi, Mom.
Let's take a look at what we saw moments ago now. Here with a scoop. And then the slam. Santana now setting up Russo after the drop kick for his patented flying forearm.
Oh, take a look at this action. Absolutely devastating. Tony Russo unable to cope with that particular maneuver on the part of the Intercontinental Champion, the great Tito Santana. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a special feature with my colleague Vince McMahon. Let's get the latest World Wrestling Federation update. You're going to find it interesting.
This week's update concerns former World Wrestling Federation champion, Mr. Bob Backlund. In an article in the official World Wrestling Federation magazine entitled The End of an Era, it documents Mr. Backlund's rise to the World Wrestling Federation to the top rung of the ladder and documents as well his injuries in sustained, however, in the match against the Iron Sheik in his fall. But also, ladies and gentlemen, it documents his determination. And it's his determination and his drive that took him to the top rung of the ladder that's likely to take him right back up there again. Let's take you now to a recent interview with Bob Backlund along with two of the principals from the Bob Backlund's Kids Tournament at his side. Let's go to the videotape.
You know, a lot of people think I was down, and I got to admit I was down. But, you know, when I was down, I found out how many friends I really had. I found out how many people were really behind me, and that really meant a lot. And I want to thank you all for all those letters, all that support. And every time I thought I was maybe finished, I went back and read a little letter, and you people said, in our hearts, you're still the champion. And I really appreciate that.
Since that interview, Mr. Backlund has stated quite flatly that, yes, indeed, he is back at a 100% capacity and looking forward to climbing up to the top rung of the ladder. We'll look forward to Bob Backlund.
Dr. D, David Shultz, one of the toughest hombres in the World Wrestling Federation today. Dr. D from Nashville, Tennessee, and a large individual at 267, meeting Francisco Vasquez from Brooklyn at 245. Vasquez really put together well, much certainly in a different fashion. Oh, look at that takeover. Dr. D asserting himself.
More organizations having great World Wrestling Federation cards in the area this Wednesday night, April 4th, at the Tunkhannock Area High School Gym in Tunkhannock, Pennsylvania. The Kiwanis Club sponsors the event, featuring the Intercontinental Champion, Tito Santana. Then on Monday, the 9th of April, in Garfield, New Jersey, the Garfield High School Gym, the Garfield High School Travel Club, will bring to town such greats as Tony Garea and Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Vasquez unable thus far to mount an offensive, but he certainly appears as though he would have a lot of power behind his punches and a lot of power indeed under normal circumstances to counter some of the tactics of Dr. D. David Shultz, who has been all over Vasquez since the outset of the match.
And Dr. David Shultz, Vince, at 267 pounds. Not only the weight, but the way the man handles it. Leveraging, brutality, everything put together makes him one of the toughest men in the World Wrestling Federation today, without a doubt.
What a slam.
Vasquez slated to give Dr. D a real run for his money. Thus far, he has been unable to counter the tactics and skills of David Shultz.
I'm certain as of late, Roddy Piper certainly having an influence on the professional wrestling career of Dr. Shultz.
Yes, an influence on the career of so many men. Shultz now.
What a slam there.
Over in the corner, Dr. D adjusting that arm bat, spins around in midair, and the elbow right into the sternum to cover. And a three count.
Did you hear that?
Yes.
Roddy Piper, beautiful.
Oh, my goodness.
Blowing out your bagpipes, Roddy Piper.
Well, Dr. D, David Shultz. Victorious. Gene, let's go back, take a look at what we saw moments ago. Devastating maneuver by Mr. Shultz.
Well, totally dominating at this particular point in time. Gigantic body slam on the part of Dr. David Shultz. Then, mounting the second rope, high in the air, tuning up that right elbow. Here he comes, flying high. Oh, right in the sternum. And that's all she wrote for Mr. Vasquez. A three count and a pinfall and a victory for Dr. David Shultz.
We'll be back as we continue with Greg the Hammer Valentine. From Boston, Mass, at 227 pounds, making his way up the ranks of the ladder in the World Wrestling Federation. Rudy Diamond, however, knowing full well that signing on to, what was that we just heard? Well, there, we take a look at Greg Valentine. The Hammer making his way to the ring. You can hear the round of boos and cheers. Beautiful robe. As we take a look at the rather broad shoulders of Mr. Valentine. Leading the way into the ring, of course, Captain Louis Albano, the voice we heard earlier on. Valentine from Seattle, Washington, at 250 pounds, has chosen once again to align himself with Louis Albano. Many would say that would be a mistake. Many would say that indeed, aligning yourself with Louis Albano is probably one of the best things you can do in professional wrestling.
Why is this guy? Come here.
Let's hear what Albano says.
This guy's got white feet at the bottom. Look, his feet are white. I don't want to. This guy's got white feet. He's got the Clorox. But the guy got white feet.
Louis Albano making some sort of observation about his opponent. Well, if Mr. Albano will vacate the premises, then we will be set for some action.
Did you see that, cameraman? That guy's got white feet.
Join us at midnight tonight here on TV9 for Championship Wrestling. Tonight at midnight on TV9, Championship Wrestling. 8 action-packed issues of the official World Wrestling Federation magazine can be yours for only $14.47. A great magazine, and if you'd like to get 8 of them, send check or money order to WWF Magazine, Post Office Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836.
Referee ushering Mr. Valentine back to the middle of the ring.
Side headlock on the part of Rudy Diamond on the multi-talented Greg the Hammer Valentine. Into the ropes. Elbow that drops Diamond to the canvas. Another flying elbow drop on the part of Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Valentine would perhaps go for the cover, choosing not to. Comment this week from Leigh Matusik from Chicago, Illinois. She writes, Dear Vince and Gene, Where does Paul Orndorff get the notion that he's Mr. Wonderful? Granted, he's an outstanding wrestler with a devastating pile driver. But his overconfident attitude surely angers quite a bit of his opponents and fans throughout the World Wrestling Federation. Someone should show Mr. Orndorff that being wonderful doesn't always necessarily lead to success.
Well, to the comments of Lee Matusik out of the Windy City, he is not the most modest man in professional wrestling today by any shadow of a doubt. I'm certain Roddy Piper has had a lot to do with that big change.
Orndorff, I'm sure you would grant, though, Gene, Orndorff has, to a certain extent, reasons
to be confident. Yes. Yes, I concur there.
An extraordinary athlete, has all the tools, both from an amateur standpoint, scientific basis, into a roughhouse brawling. Orndorff, really a gifted athlete, I would think.
Right now, Rudy Diamond on the receiving end of some pretty good punishment at the hands of Greg Valentine.
Elbow to the back of the head, it appeared. Valentine, front face lock. Uh-oh. Looks like he's trying to set him up. He does. Up in the air now. Devastating suplex.
Hold on.
And step over. And Valentine. There it is.
The figure four.
Greg Valentine polishing off his opponent. And a fashion that we have grown accustomed to. The figure four leg lock is only Greg Valentine can apply.
By submission, Greg Valentine. Figure four leg lock, and actually Valentine dominated that match, Vince, from start to finish over Rudy Diamond.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh. Back on the leg now, Valentine. Finally, the referee asserting himself as Lou Albano momentarily distracted referee Dick Worley. And if Valentine has an opportunity, you bet he's going to take advantage. Let's go to what we saw moments ago.
All right. Greg Valentine in action. Big vertical suplex taking Rudy Diamond high in the air.
For the benefit of those of you who'd like to drop us a line this week, as did a young lady from the windy city of Chicago, Illinois, we certainly do invite you to do so. We enjoy your comments and questions. We ask you to write to us here at World Wrestling Federation Headquarters, P.O. Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836. We'll be back in a moment.
In action, returning to Madison Square Garden for you, the great fans of the Big Apple in this entire area, Monday, April the 23rd. By the way, I should point out, Sergeant Slaughter has been signed on this card to meet a suitable opponent one-on-one. Details will be forthcoming. Come on in, if you would, Captain Lou Albano, before
May
you
say one thing, man, Gene. At the last encounter, we all know what happened. Both men were counted out of that ring. Now, we know Bob Backlund's ability. I filmed this match in entirety. And looking at the films and reviewing them, I feel we were just a little ahead. Just a little ahead of Bob Backlund. We had him right where we wanted him. It was going to be a tough victory, but I felt we had the man, and then both men got counted out. But this time, it'll be a decisive win.
All right, one-on-one, a return bout. Yes, you, Greg the Hammer Valentine, to meet great Bob Backlund.
Madison Square Garden, the greatest arena in the world. Once again, I'll be sashaying down that aisle. The long blonde hair blowing in the breeze. The $3,000 rhinestone studded beautiful robes that I wear. And once those robes come on, we're going to clash again. Me and you, Bobby Backlund. Nobody else, just me and you head on. And this time there will be a winner. The captain said that I was ahead on points. I believe I was ahead on points also, Bobby Backlund. And then you had the audacity to put that chicken wing hold on me outside the ring. But I broke it. I broke that hold of yours, Bobby Backlund. That proves that I'm better than you. And I will, because I'm a master of science and professional wrestling, I will put that figure four leg lock on you this time. I will maim you. I will cripple you. I'll either cripple that left arm, that gippy left arm of yours, with that left leg.
And this time, Greg, we're going to party.
Thank you very much. I'm sorry. Very good. Thank you. Lou Albano, gentlemen, come on in, if you would, please. Six-man tag team action to be part of the next great one at the Madison Square Garden. Get this, Piper, Shultz, Orndorff on one side to meet this very distinguished trio, tag team champions, Tony Atlas, Rocky Johnson, and you, Ivan Putski.
Well, you know, we're ready for these guys. I got two of the best wrestlers in the world, Tony Atlas and Rocky Johnson. What more can a man ask for? Protection, it's there. Teamwork, it's there. Just bring them on, huh, Tony?
That's right, Tony.
That's my birthday.
I wanted to say that.
23rd, you wanted, I'm
you're
sorry.
You're going to be getting some birthday presents, some birthday
cake,
perhaps.
I'm sorry, but I wanted to tell them folks that's my birthday. And I can't think of a better way than to celebrate my birthday than to team up with two good friends like Ivan Putski, Rocky Johnson, going against two no-good dogs as that Shultz, Piper, and that Orndorff. Now, I couldn't have a better birthday present. If it was Thanksgiving, I would still be just as happy because we would have three turkeys, which I'm not saying that about them gentlemen, because anybody wrestling the WWF, now, they could give me a birthday present that I wouldn't like. But as long as I got two men like this on my side and we looking out to each other, we ain't worrying about too much.
I thank you very much,
that's
gentlemen.
My
I hate
birthday.
To cut you short. Happy
that is
birthday.
My birthday.
In advance, Tony Atlas, Ivan Putski, and, of course, Rocky Johnson, part of the great card six-man tag team bout. Come on in, if you would. Bob Backlund, a man that reigns supreme in Madison Square Garden for a long, long, many, many years. Now a return bout. A lot of issues still to be settled between Greg Valentine and yourself.
Yeah, first I'd like to thank Mr. Wolf, the Special Olympics. I was at Norman Thomas High School, and I had an opportunity to work with the Special Olympics the day after the last Gardens, and I had a heck of a time there, and I signed a contract with Greg Valentine for the return, and I'm looking forward to that. A lot of people are wondering what this, and asked me about this medal that I met that day after and the day of the Garden. This medal means a lot.
If our cameraman could get a shot, I'd like to have him get a close-up on that.
That medal, something that when I was off laying there thinking and trying to train and trying to do everything, I was at a swimming meet and my daughter was swimming in that, and I was there cheering for her, fighting for her to win. And the day I left for the Garden, she gave me this medal. She knew how bad I was hurt by losing the WWF championship and to be taken out of the chance to get it back. She said, Dad, you take this medal and you keep it until you get the WWF belt or back around your waist. Greg Valentine's tough, but I'm going to give it 100%. I'm not going to let anybody down. I remember the things my family does for me. I remember the things my friends do for me. The last thing she said was, don't lose the medal.
Madison Square Garden, April 23rd. It's a Monday night. We'll see you there.
Welding.
Crazy, or it's actually Orndorff who's going a little bit nuts. He does not like to be referred to as Paula. It's Paul Orndorff, not Paula.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled one fall with a 10-minute time limit, introducing you to the corner to my right from Mexico City, weighing in at 227 pounds, making his first appearance in this arena, here is Santiago Rios. And in the corner to my left, from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 262 pounds, here is Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, you can tell by the jeers and the boos. Uh-oh. Here they go again.
road. Certainly, this upcoming Friday night, April 6th, will be to Uniondale, Long Island, for the World Wrestling Federation Spectacular at the Nassau Coliseum. There are still great seats on sale at the Coliseum box office and Ticketron, a ladies' tag team matchup. Samoan number one, Ivan Putski, the Iron Sheik, just a few of the great names who are coming to Nassau Coliseum. This Friday night, April the 6th, action begins at 8 p.m.
Rios!
Oh, no! Oh, what a devastating maneuver. And again, we hear the chant. Unfortunately for Mr. Rios, Orndorff is picking out his frustration. Oh, my, forget it! Orndorff almost took the head off of Santiago Rios.
Just about decapitated Rios, Vince.
Up in the air now. We've seen this move many times before. Pole driver right down on the canvas.
It should be barred.
The cover, you can count to 100.
Absolutely no chance.
Roddy Piper enters the ring with another victory under his belt, in the belt of Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Let's get the official time.
It is the winner, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Orndorff victorious. Let's go to what we saw moments ago here.
Well, here's the setup on the pile driver. And Mr. Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful, can execute this one to perfection. I've stated time and time again, this one should be... Oh! Absolutely no chance for the native of Mexico City, Mexico, Santiago Rios. Big win and a subsequent three count for the pin for Paul Orndorff.
In
something
a moment,
else.
Yes, indeed. In a moment, ladies and gentlemen, we should like to take you to Piper's Pit. Before we do, we'd like to remind you that the views expressed in Piper's Pit, those of Mr. Piper alone and those of his guests, and not necessarily those of us here on the World Wrestling Federation Network. With that in mind, ladies and gentlemen, we take you now to Piper's Pit.
I'm having such a good time this week. All kinds of things are going along. I got this fella here, Terry Daniels. What a snazzy young fella. A nice-looking, snazzy uniform. I got to ask you something. Got to ask you something right off the top of my head. First of all, Terry, it's nice to have you here.
Thank you very much.
I want to ask you. I see all kinds of movies. I see all kinds of movies where the drill instructor, he's got a... First of all, let me introduce this fella. His name is Terry Daniels. He's from the Forces, now a member with Slaughter of a Cobra Corps. And I've seen these movies... Now, just a second. Listen to this. I've seen these movies where these drills instructors, they come down and they start like, can you hear me? G.I. Joe, G.I. Joe, fighting. Are you, first of all, you wouldn't, after saying G.I. Joe and can you hear me and all that other stuff, I see it in the movies, we got you here in person, you can't tell me sincerely that you're going to stand there and let some geek like that yell in your face, say all this stuff, and not do anything. Surely it's just in the movies, honey.
Yes, sir, it's called mental discipline.
Wait a second, are you telling me yes, they do this to you, or no, they don't, it's only in the movies?
No, sir, they do it. It's called mental discipline.
Do you have a mental problem? Why?
The reason for this is it gives you self-dedication. It helps you prepare for this. If you can handle the yelling and everything, then you can handle anything.
Wait, just a second. This guy, you were trying to tell me if I was a drill instructor, I can get up on you and say all kinds of nasty things about your sister, and you're just going to stand there and take it without any repercussion. Me, myself, I haven't done anything anybody's told me my whole life. I didn't bother going in the armed forces like the Marines because, first of all, they couldn't handle someone. Do you think they could handle someone like myself in the Marines?
Yes.
Do you think... Hey, it's good. Hey, it's opinion. At least you're being honest. What I'm saying to you is you get a guy like Sergeant Slaughter...
the drill instructor. Now, just a second. There's a whole bunch of Iranians out there, and they all got rifles shooting at you, and you're hiding under the table. He says, get up, you nothing, and go fight them, and you're going to get shot for sure. Are you going to go?
Yes, sir.
You're nuts.
Just a minute, Mr. Piper. The man, he's got pride. He's an American. He loves what he does. That's just it. If he tells me to do that, I'm going to do it because I'm an American. I love my country, and I'll do whatever it takes to fight for it. That's just it. I'm a Marine. I'm proud to be a Marine, and I'm proud to become a member of the elite force of the Cobra Corps. Thank you, sir.
The Cobra Corps? The Cobra Corps is a bunch of brownies that can't find the campfire. Get off the air. Get the hook out. I'm the boss. Take them off the air, man.
Oh, my goodness. Back up to action now in the ring. I'm sure we'll be hearing about that Piper's Pit.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest that is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from Chinatown, New York City, weighing 230 pounds, here is Lee Wong. And his opponent from Kansas City, weighing in at 248 pounds, here is Cowboy Bob Orton.
Well, there's an hombre for you, Cowboy Bob Orton, a man who just exudes professional wrestling credentials. Here we go, Orton against Wong.
The Bishop O'Reilly High School Gym in Kingston, Pennsylvania hosts World Wrestling Federation action on Monday night, the 9th of April. On the card, such greats as Mr. Fuji and Superfly Jimmy Snuka. On Tuesday night, the 10th of April, in Lindenhurst, Long Island, at the Lindenhurst High School Gym, you're going to see on the card Tony Atlas and Sergeant Slaughter. And then Wednesday, the 11th of April, in Sayreville, New Jersey, at the Sayreville High School Gym, Tito Santana and Dr. D. David Shultz on the card.
Orton maintaining control over Lee Wong. Cut. There's Roddy Piper again. We might remind you this copyrighted telecast is being brought to you by the authority of the World Wrestling Federation and Titan Sports Incorporated. Any rebroadcasts or the use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the telecast, including the imposition of a charge without the express written consent of the World Wrestling Federation, is prohibited. Ah, look at this. Oh, forget it.
I've had an opportunity on and off through the years to cover matches with Cowboy Bob Orton, second generation, and a great one. Sometimes bending to the rules, but he's as tough as they come.
Sometimes a blatant break of the rules. And Orton now apparently aligning himself with Mr. Piper. Oh, my! Very interesting young man we saw moments ago, Terry Daniels. Earlier on, we had an occasion to have a chat with Mr. Daniels, and he was telling us about how proud that, as a matter of fact, he claims it's the greatest occasion of his life to be the first inductee into the Cobra Corps.
You know, Vince, you talk about discipline. Just during the course of that particular interview with Rowdy Roddy Piper, he showed magnificent self-discipline.
Yes, he did. I wonder what kind of discipline it takes to be a member of the Cobra Corps. I don't think we would want to know. Look at this.
Uh-oh.
Orton with Lee Wong.
Oh!
Covers him. And a three count.
You have got to be kidding.
Cowboy Bob Orton. My goodness.
Never in my life have I seen such a move.
A super suplex. Let's get the official time.
Here is the winner, Cowboy Bob Orton.
Cowboy Bob Orton victorious. Let's take a closer look at what we saw just moments ago.
I can't believe the setup. Lee Wong, of course, straddling that top turnbuckle. Take a look at Orton. Front face lock, and now the move that takes Lee high in the air. And it was all over. That's all she wrote for Mr. Lee Wong. Victorious Cowboy Bob Orton.
When we return, ladies and gentlemen, our feature attraction this week, we'll find out just how rowdy Roddy Piper really is when he dons the tights and S.D. Jones' opponent. Very much looking forward to it.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner to my right, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 240 pounds, here is S.D., Special Delivery Jones. And his opponent, from Glasgow, Scotland, weighing 232 pounds, here is Rowdy Roddy Piper.
You can bet that a lot of people are watching this matchup, and a defeat would cost Mr. Piper great sums of prestige and no doubt would somewhat deflate that humongous ego of Mr. Piper. And S.D. Jones, just a man that can do it. Piper being taunted by this capacity crowd, and Piper's going to have more problems, I'm sure. Piper adjusting his coat. We certainly hope that he remembered to bring along his tights. There we go.
Thank goodness.
Piper attempting to use some psychology here. Just sort of throwing her. Oh, are you serious? A moment ago, it would appear that Mr. Piper wanted to start things off on a friendly basis. All right, lock up now to the ropes. And a clean break by Mr. Piper. SD looking at it, a southpaw at his hand cocked.
Based on track record, Roddy Piper certainly very capable when it comes to wrestling itself.
Locking up again. And behind him, nice takedown by Piper. Trying to find a handle here. SD in does somewhat.
Mark the date down of Tuesday, April 10th, if you live in the area of Howell, New Jersey. A World Wrestling Federation spectacular coming to the Howell High School gym. Among those signed to appear in tag team action will be Superfly Jimmy Snuka and Tito Santana at the Howell High School gym, April 10th. Then on April 15th, a Sunday night, the action will shift to Norwalk, Connecticut at the Norwalk High School gym. Among those on the bill, a ladies tag team matchup and the one and only Ivan Putski.
Mr. Piper showing his true colors. Another right hand. You can hear the chant, SD.
What a right, though, by Piper. Absolutely devastating.
Piper wrenching the neck area and perhaps caught the fingers in the open mouth of SD.
Like it or not, Vince, I'm going to tell you, I am impressed thus far.
Off the rope, back, no. All right, sunset flip. Piper, one, two, no. Oh, my. Piper, back in control, rams, from our vantage point, it appeared as though he rammed the thumb into the esophagus of S.D. Jones.
Very cleverly shielding himself from the referee.
Boy, do these people want Piper to lose. Oh.
Not going to win a lot of popularity contests, no doubt about that.
Look at that maneuver. Roddy Piper. At the moment, maintaining control over Special Delivery Jones. The match, I think, far from being over yet. Piper. Applying more pressure to the chin area. Pulling up on one hand, pushing down on the other. Roddy Piper. Attempting to display his wrestling skill. You can bet those whom he manages are looking on. as well as the entire country. All right, El Steve to the left and a headbutt. Piper reeling around.
He doesn't even know where he's at.
El Steve moving in, and Piper for the ride. My goodness.
Gigantic field throw on a part of S.D. Jones.
Oh, my, and S.D. Look at the expression of Piper's face.
Oh.
From behind, takes him up. Atomic knee drop. And the fans really supporting S.D. They are behind him all the way.
Piper in trouble.
Piper hammering away. What a series of rights and lefts. To the rope now, and off. Back body, no. Neckbreaker by Piper. So Piper spinning things right back around, too. I can't believe it.
Well, I am somewhat surprised.
Roddy Piper, just like that, gets the Duke. Look at the smile on Piper's face.
What an arrogant individual.
We will get the official verdict here.
It is the winner, Roddy Piper.
Piper having a tough time of it all the way through the match. Nonetheless, it'll go down in the record book as a victory for Roddy Piper. SD really gave him a run for his money. We'll go back and pick up the action we saw moments ago.
Well, here, Piper, into the ropes. Look at this. Neck breaker, and that was the coup de grace. That's all she wrote for the native of the city of brotherly love, S.D. Jones. Victory, as you indicated, Vince McMahon, like it or not, Roddy Piper, victorious here on television in the World Wrestling Federation for the first time.
For the benefit of those who'd like to drop us a line, we certainly invite you to do so, as did Maria Delgato from Phoenix, Arizona earlier on. We invite you to write to Wrestling, P.O. Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836. We'll be back as you continue with more action.
Following AMCO.
To Long Island, Nassau Coliseum, this Friday night, 8 p.m. And ladies and gentlemen, it truly reads like the who's who in all of professional wrestling. Plenty of good seats are still available for the big one this Friday night. Captain Lou Albano, come on in, along with your man, Wild Samoans, top international stars this Friday night, including your man.
Very peg, baby. What would you like to know about my champions? Offer and Seeker.
Well, they're no longer champions, but we can certainly discuss their involvement in this Friday night's big card out on Long Island.
Well, now this Friday night, they're going to be singly individualized. They're going to be out on their own. I took the match, I signed the contract, basically to prove to a dummy like you and to all the fans out there that as an individual effort, they are still as effective as a combined effort. In other words, they don't have to...
Wait a minute.
Singly or as a team, or as a combined effort, or with the captain, they can do it all, brother. Go ahead, ask me, son, Jack.
I am going to go ahead and, if I may, approach these two men and try to engage.
What he said is, you don't speak fluent Samoan. Ask the captain, and I'll tell you no lie.
How do you say Nassau Coliseum?
Nassau Coliseum?
In Samoan.
In Samoan. Nassau Coliseum. Nassau Coliseum. Nassau Coliseum. That's Nassau Coliseum.
All right. Individually, not as a tag team, I'm very curious. What do you feel? What is the interruption?
Individually, si ka bala kada boka para biya. Iko bala pa una e pasala. Boka na.
I thank you very much. Not getting a long, long way. Very good. I thank you. Top names: Ivan Putski, Bob Backlund, Balomo, Strongbow. They're all going to be at the Nassau County Coliseum, World Wrestling Federation action this Friday night. In the World Wrestling Federation, he's built like a Sherman tank. Putski, originally from Krakow, Poland, at 240 pounds, set to lock up against a very large individual here from Texas at 277 pounds, Johnny Ringo. Here we go.
Another outstanding World Wrestling Federation card will be coming to Madison Square Garden on Monday night, April the 23rd. Tremendous action from start to finish. Tito Santana defends the Intercontinental title against Samoan number one. Tony Atlas, Rocky Johnson, and Ivan Putski in a six-man tag against Roddy Piper, David Shultz, and Paul Orndorff. And a return bout, Bob Backlund meeting Greg the Hammer Valentine, highlight the Madison Square Garden Wrestling Extravaganza, Monday, April 23rd.
Putski with a side headlock. Ringo picked up earlier on like a sack of potatoes, slammed down to the canvas. Putski really power packed.
You know,
that's the rope. Beg your pardon, Gene.
Nearly 40-pound weight advantage of Johnny Ringo certainly is not shown thus far during the course of this particular bout.
Putski, oh my. How about that? Off the rope, here he comes again. Just bowls Johnny Ringo down. Ringo whipped outside, trying to hang on to the rope. Momentum taking him all the way through to the hardwood floor.
Your analogy to a Sherman tank, I think, quite apropos.
Watch your hand.
Putski, some kind of a physical specimen.
Look at this.
Oh, just manhandling him.
Yes, he is. Putski, half-over takedown. And Putski tightening his grip a bit. Polish power. Really teaching Mr. Ringo thus far a lesson. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, next week to join us will be no less than the former World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund. Mr. Backlund set to square off against formidable opposition. We will certainly look forward to the presence of Mr. Backlund on the card next week. Putski now ramming the knee and pulling back on the chin area. And Ringo, even though a larger individual, has had very little success, if any at all, against the Polish power.
Well, Ivan Putski, certainly one of the premier wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation today. Flying mare, nearly 280 pounds, popping over in a big hurry.
Well, it's been all Ivan Putski. Ringo yet to really mount an offensive of any kind. Putski now backs him to the rope, shoves him. Oh, there it is, the patented Polish hammer. Putski puts him away, I think. Yes, indeed.
Wow.
So that was, I would suspect, nothing more than a tune-up match for the Polish power. Ivan, having very little difficulty and destroying Johnny Ringo. And Ringo at 277 pounds, just no match for Ivan Putski. Putski, as we stated before, originally from Krakow, Poland, grew up in the West Texas area. An extraordinary athlete, well-rounded athlete. And there, ladies and gentlemen, to join us next week, as we said it before, Bob Backlund. And by the way, joining Mr. Backlund on hand next week will be the one and the only Sergeant Slaughter, front and center, along with the Tonga Kid, who sets his sights on Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. That should be really an outstanding matchup. And then from there, an individual competition, Tony Atlas will be on hand. And then later on, we'll look forward to the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. And in Piper's Pit next week, the Pride of Pawhuska, Oklahoma, Chief Jay Strongbow. And oh yes, by the way, to join us as well, from Tehran, Iran, the Iron Sheik. We'll look forward to those individuals and many more joining us next week here on All Star Wrestling. So until next week, this is Vince McMahon along with Mean Gene Okerlund saying so long.